Hello everyone, Talvard and Flippy here, and today I'm going to do something different. As you can see, I have a map editor open for Tiberian Dawn, which allows me to edit like multiplayer maps. So what I'm going to do with this one, I'm basically going to convert this map in a mission. And and I'm going to add AI and functioning bases on this map. And first of all, let's start with some important things. Let's go to the basic first. And player is basically means that basically means, I guess these are used for multiplayer, special, neutral, good guy and bad guy. But all I'm going to focus on is on good guy and bad guy. Basically, this is GDI and this is not. And I'm going to make this... I'm going to make you play as a GDI and you need to destroy the not base that is in this map. And for that you need to select a good guy if you want to be GDI, and if you want to be bad guy, you need to be Nod. And build level, I think that's like attack level. Like, and I've seen on other maps, like the single player maps on the last level, it's set on 98s, which give you full tech. And I should be done with this now. Yes. So yeah, this mission is now basically a... This map is basically now a mission. Because I added the good guys as a player and the bad guys as the not, as the enemies. And but for now there is nothing on the map. Like, you don't have a base yet and the enemy don't have a base yet, but... I'm going to focus on the enemy base first. And there's another important thing you need to do to make the bases work. At least that AI going to build buildings. And that's by going to edit, triggers, select new, and you can name this whatever you want. I think it can be up to a certain amount of characters, I think so. Yes. And let's make this a PROD, which you basically, I'm going to make a trigger that triggers AI to build the buildings. And that's going to be based on time, event, production, count. Basically means when the trigger is going to work. Which in this case, if I set it to 0, the trigger is going to work right away. Which means they start building right away. That is what you want. What I want to have. Because I'm want to simulate like a scavenger game with this map. So I'm going to keep that to 0s. Site, bad guy, team type. You don't need that for production. Loop. Also, yeah, you can make the trigger loop, or you can only make it happen once. And, I guess I'm going to make it in loop. And as I have seen or heard, at least all the Westwood made maps, the missions from this game, I set the 2 in loop. I don't know why, I don't know what's the difference between 1 and 2, but, yeah, I set them in 2 myself, and they work fine. So, yeah. Now the AI is able to build buildings, but as you can see, the AI don't have a base yet to build from. And you kind of need to give them a blueprint to construct the base. But I want to place the main base like over here, and maybe like a small outpost over here or something. But by doing that, I need some room first, so I'm gonna drag a box up to there. No, like this. I'm going to right click, clear terrain, clear overlay, and clear with template. So this place is clear. I'm going to remove this tip as well, because it's in the way. Like this. And I want to remove this as well, so that I have space to work with. And let's remove terrain and overlay. Yeah, and maybe I should remove the little thing up there. You can also do it manually yourself, but on this side you can pick different objects and you can switch between tabs like one for buildings, one for vehicles and shit. But yeah, let's first start to make a wall. I'm doing it like this. I'm going to drag a box over here. Right click, fill with concrete wall, and this is the main base. Like, I'm going to remove these pieces in the corners. This. So you have a nice square that you can work on. And yeah, I want to have an entrance up here. Like this. And maybe a small one. I should remove this. I should remove that. So yeah, let's remove that little slide or something or whatever it is. Like that. So yeah, and let's have a main entrance over here and another one over here. Like this. Perfect. So yeah, and let's give them some buildings by going through structures general. And the first thing you want to have them have in the first place is a construction yard, so they can build from that. You can place it right in the corner here, like so it's protected by the other buildings, pretty basically. And yeah, and I want to already start with a power plant. And also, I should explain this. The way the AI is going to build the base is in the order that you place the building. Like, if you build like two power plants at first and then the barracks, the AI will always build the two power plants first and then the barracks. It's in the order that you have placed the buildings. I think I'm gonna let them start with the two power plants, and then I'm going to have a refinery up here, maybe? Or should it be up here? I think it's fine, and yeah. A finally, and then they should build a hand of nod. It's right there. You can just place it like this. And then, for example, have another power plant. And let's make sure they have an airstrip that they're going to build next. Wait. I think I'm going to place some silos first so that I can store a little bit of money, like. Oops, not like that. Like this. Nice. And then they can have an airstrip down there. Like this. So there's already part of the base done. And yeah, let's keep adding more stuff. Yeah, and let's. What should I give them? I think they should build a radar up next. And where should I put it? I guess right here. And then maybe in the corner. Oops. Not like this. More power plants. And down here. So that should give the AI plenty of power, and then. What should I give them next? I guess I can give them a temple of not because for scenery. I can place it like up here. Nice, and again, and then no wait. I should give them a power plant there first, and then put a temple in the middle there. That is going to look nice. Like this. And yeah. And let's see. Let's give them like. Then one more power plant up here, maybe two. Yes, that's fine. And then I should give them. I can give them some base defenses. I'm gonna start with some gun turrets over here and over here, one there and one there. And wait, maybe I should move that and not a little bit. Now that's going to screw up the base building order if I remove that. So basically, if I have to do that, I'm gonna have to remove everything, like this, structure, and then remove structure, and then delete. Oops, delete. No, I said delete this. So, let's do it again. Let's see, power plant, refinery, silo, and another power plant, two, and then, let's make a barracks like this. And then they should make an airstrip. Let's see, where do I want to put the temple? I think up here. I'm going to set this as a template for now. And they should have a... No, I think I should build a radar there. They should build a radar there. Like this. And I can remove this. And now I want him to have like more power plants. I should also remove these. Nice. And maybe I can give them like two extra silos up there. Like this. So they can store plenty of money. And yeah, let's see. Then more up there. Nice. And this should give them more than enough power to keep the base functioning. And at last, let's put the temple up there. And yeah, this is how the base is going to look like if I start the game. And I also need to do something in every building, and that's like add some properties to it. But I'm gonna do that later. I'm gonna first finishing the base. And then I want them to have gun turrets up here and down here. And then right next to the gun turrets, I'm going to place an obelisk here, and here. So the base is defended. And then I can add some site like over here, and over here. And it is going to protect them against ground forces and air forces. And yeah, that's basically. I'm already done with the base, so. Oh fuck me! I forgot to change something. I forgot to say change something. I should have changed this to a bad guy. So I'm gonna replace everything off camera. So yeah. Okay, we're back, and I have changed the buildings to bad guy, and now the AI will actually build the structure. And I have even added a little bit. I've added two helipads, so the AI have a little bit air units, but they don't really use the air units that much. And and the other thing I wanted to have is to have a little bit more terrarium close by, like one field up here and maybe one field up here. That should give them enough terrarium to harvest for a while. And yeah, let's give one up here. Like this, fill with terrarium. And one up here. Fill with terrarium. And then like this, fill with terrarium. I'm going to place like small pieces right next to each other to make the field look a little bit more natural, like this. Because now it kind of looks like a square, and yeah. Okay, that looks already a little bit better, and let's put like one up here. And something up there, like this. So the AI have enough terrarium to harvest, and I want to give it a blossom tree as well. Let's go, and that's by placing like a tree right on there, and there. And the terrarium will constantly regrow over this area and this area. And yeah, I can place one over here. And yeah. So the AI have plenty of tip to harvest, and what should I do? I guess I should say let's test if they are building Oh wait, there's one more thing I need to do before I do that. And that's like double click on a building and then check the start, uncheck the start, because otherwise you're going to start with a whole base, and that's not what I want in this map. I want them to build their own base and build their own forces. And yeah, I'm gonna do that to every building, and I see you guys. Okay, and we're back. I've unchecked every building with the start, so they don't start with the building. The only thing they start with is a construction yard, which they need to build a base, and yeah. And also, there's another important thing to do to make AI even build bases is to give them money, because they AI have no money, and with no money, they can produce stuff. And that's by going to edit, site, bad guy, and let's give them like 5,000, that should be enough to build the base, and press OK. And yeah, and the way you want to save the map, like I already made a save file for this map, and that's by clicking save as, going to your command and conquer directory, and naming it scg44ea or any random number. The G stand for GDI, and the B stand for NAD. But I'm named this one G. This one is going to be on the GDI. And yeah, it's, you can find it in the new missions tab on the main menu. I'm gonna show you that now. And yeah. Right, sure, let's replace it. Yeah, I'm gonna show you if the AI works. Let's go in to the game. Oh, how exciting. And yeah, let's wait for OBS to pick up the game. It takes a while for OBS to pick it up, and yeah, I don't know why. There we go, OBS is working, and yes, this is the map I'm just edited. And yeah, let's see if the AI starts to produce stuff. And I'm gonna turn on this game speed first, and I'm going to do something, and that's type in tactical on my keyboard. Like this, and that reveals the whole map like this, and yeah. You can see we don't have a base yet. We don't, I guess with GDI now, but we don't have a base yet. Like, I have not added it yet, but the enemies should have. Like, they have a construction yard over here, and they should build a base up here, and let's turn up the game speed. Yeah, and let's wait until the structures are going to pop up. Yep, like this. And then they should build a... Yep. And they have one harvester. Like, I'm going to give them one harvester, because AI don't really need a lot of harvesters to function. Because the thing is, AI gets a lot of resources by only one harvester. So, yeah. You get a lot more resources than you do. Like, one harvester don't instantly give them full silos. And yeah, I'm not going to give them like 20 harvesters. That's literally no point to do that. Because I'm just going to keep collecting here, keep collecting terbium and returning it to the refinery. But yeah, as you can see, the AI is building his base, but it will not build units because I don't have added those yet. And yeah. And yeah, that's I'm gonna cut the recording a little bit, and I'm gonna show you when the AI is a little bit further with the base. So yeah. And hello, we're back, and as you can see, the AI is almost done with his base. He already put some defenses, he's going to put up obelisks soon, and yeah. But like I said, they will not build units, and yeah. And they're going to build for obelisks I told them to do, like up here, and down here, for protection, and yeah. It seems this is working right, and it seems the AI is doing a good job by building his base. Like there are a few things you need to be careful with, and that is don't put buildings in places where it's blocked. Otherwise, the AI will not build the base entirely right. And that, which means like if there's an obstacle, for example, on this power plant, then the AI will not build a base because it's trying to place there and it can't, because the AI is following the blueprint script I gave them. Like, and that's placing the buildings in the order I placed them. And yeah. And as you can see, the AI is finishing construction, and yeah. Last obelisk, and the base is done. And as you can see, the AI have plenty of bearing with the harvest from. Like, they have a field up here I added, they have one up here I added, they have this field over here, this field, that one. And then the player have the Stabarium, actually. Yeah, I think this base looks nice. And yeah, and I guess this concludes the end of the first video. And yeah, I'm going to split one into parts, because making this right takes time. And I don't want to make a video for like 5 hours long. And yeah, I hope you. But yeah, anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. And yeah, I see you in the next one. Take care and bye bye.